on Sunday, or mid-afternoon. Not too much traffic yet. This is the Hilton Tower. It goes a little ways up. As you can see, a lot of Venezuela is very poor. And in the upper mountains there, that's how they live. They come in from all over South America. Venezuela seems to be the richer of the countries. You're looking at a lot of people that come in from Colombia, as well as Peru. They come and they live in these little dwellings on the hillside. The majority of these people work in the restaurants and hotels located here in the city. Caracas. This is how you can see the little dwellings, apartments, across from us from the Hilton. See downtown. Sitting up on top about the 20th floor, you can see they get a beautiful garden down below. This is the area around the family. Beautiful area. See the vendors outside the gate. Selling their wares, statues of the Blessed Mother.
Hey, Mr. Lane. Sorry, France is killing the United States.
This is the church that they have built right in front of the grotto. And then you can see the grotto. Absolutely gorgeous. Nestled among the trees. Beautiful flowers, candles. These are plaques that all the visitors
the Blessed Mother has granted a wish. They come and leave a plaque and thank the Blessed Mother for everything she has done for them. That is our guide, George, talking to two of our friends that are on this day trip with us. Here you notice we've got a woman who walks, who's walking on her knees as a petition to the Blessed Mother.
It's kind of, you know, embarrassing to have the gate, but, you know, too many people are sick, and you feel this bottle.
People can drink.
Many people for many hours during the line.
With the holy water.
So they made this just
from the water coming down next to the grotto.
And normally, it's where it feels here. It's here. Thank you.
Yeah. It's already raining. I just hit the top button.
This is the first convent that we're going to visit. This is the convent that we are about to get into. And you can see the gates starting to open for us. And this is the bus. View from the convent, overlooking Las Tecas. This is the road up, and you can see how the different people, how they live.
Fresh air.
And then you go to the more expensive homes. See the countryside. How some of the dwelling people live here on the hills.
Thank you.
if we can see the, this is the little patio at the condo.
So we'll be in Caracas this afternoon.
That was George walking by, our guy.
Yes, sure.
He was communicating with some of the other tourists, guides in the area. Just another view from the convent, facing north. Gorgeous part of the country.
You got my camera? Huh? Alright, go get some more.
You see this house here. That pipeline going to it is gas. That's how they get their gas up to the different homes up in the high country. This is just a little courtyard on the side of the convent. Side entrance into the chapel. This was the gate that we had just come through, the gated gate. Entrance into the convent, a back shot of it. Just to give you an idea of part of the countryside on the south side of the convent. Beautiful country. See the clouds coming in over the mountains. An apartment like this, you get like a three bedroom house, two baths, run about, you can buy it for about $10,000. See, they've kind of taken a page out of the American way of living. They're starting to build little pads and placing their little chalets. These will run you about $5,000. Build yourself a little place. Have the engineer build you a little place. It costs you $34 to have your hookup for your gas and your electric. And then well, you pay a monthly fee on these type of homes. But some of the little chalets that you see and some of the little shacks, these people pay a hookup fee of about $34, and then they don't pay a monthly fee at all. From that point forth, it's kind of free. The gardens, as you can see, are gorgeous. Flowers are just absolutely gorgeous and huge. you can see, the local dwellers have all the conveniences of home. They let the sun do their drying. That's their dryer in their home. As you can see, some of the hill dwellers, these people build their, they're all engineers. They build their own homes, and alongside the taller buildings that you see out there are all apartments, condos. You can see this one guy here with a little antenna. Since these people build their own homes, they don't have to pay taxes or monthly fees for the electricity that they use. So they'll spend a lot of their money buying stereos and TVs and VCRs, because they don't have to spend a monthly fee for rent or utilities. This is the convent, or actually the church, where the bleeding hose is kept and where the services were at the time the hose started to bleed. This is the opening into the church of where the host, and we will be able to observe the host, the bleeding host.
O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine.
Can we take a picture of it?
Yes, as far as I know. Sorry, I don't have my camera. Well, I guess you can touch up here, but yeah, I think so. Yeah. It doesn't want us to be touching. You can touch close, I think, like this.
Father, would you offer us one of the intentions today? You can push the button at the bottom, and it'll make it fly real quick.
This is a little grotto of our Blessed Mother next to the church that we just attended services.
Thank you.
Here's where Maria lives when she's not down in the city. She lives here. This is right below the grotto. Here's where she comes when she stays and has guests and visits. She's usually here on weekends and holy days. Right now she's in the United States. In fact, she's in Philadelphia. Here in Venezuela, those who have a little bit more means have, this is what they call like a summer home, where you go for the weekends and holidays. There's a little patio in the back where they rest.
Cada uno busquemos a Jesús, busquemos Santa María como reina y madre, como reina y madre de todos los criados. María se hace presente aquí llamándonos a la conversión, llamándonos al estar con su Hijo Jesús. Por eso debemos pedir a Jesús, a nuestro Jesús, que nos ayude a orar, que nos enseñe a orar como enseñó a los discípulos. También debemos pedir a María, nuestra madre, que nos enseñe a ser un Espíritu Santo. Jesús vive, hermano, Jesús está vivo. María, nuestra madre, nos lo dice, Él está vivo, Él está presente. Por eso tú no estás aquí por casualidad, tú estás aquí por voluntad divina, por voluntad de Dios, tu madre, proclamando con María la grandeza del Señor. Mi alma proclama la grandeza del Señor y mi espíritu se alegra en el Dios Salvador.
This is the motley group, and there's Reed, Brian, Carol, I think Father's too tired to wave. I think Father's too tired to wave.
Sin estar seguro de lo que te estás encontrando, tú tienes que callar.
callar, meditar, pensar, y el Señor se hará sentir. Entonces debemos ser muy justos, muy conscientes, muy equilibrados, más que todo, con un gran espíritu de serenidad. Porque la serenidad está el Señor, está su madre. La serenidad es la madre, que todo lo va a solucionar. Porque al estar sereno, se va equilibrando el ambiente, se van quitando las tensiones, van desapareciendo, y llena a nosotros la armonía total, para así sentirnos nuevos, renovados totalmente, limpios de corazón, y con un gran espíritu de soportación a las malas malas interpretaciones que tengan de nosotros, perdonando siempre y amando, y dando de nosotros lo mejor, porque ese mejor no nos pertenece, ese mejor que tenemos nosotros viene de Dios. Ese es el que manda, es el Señor. Entonces, no vamos a contaminarnos con el mundo de pecado, con el hombre que blasfema, con aquel que dice, con el otro que aconteció, que dijeron de ti, que si es, no, eso no se escucha. Vamos a escuchar las cosas buenas que vienen del cielo, las cosas verdaderamente lógicas, aquellas que nos dan estímulo para seguir adelante, no para que aquello que nos quite la fe, nos quite la confianza y debamos sucumbir bajo la mano del enemigo, ¿no? Eso no lo afecte nunca, nunca, eso es para atrás, eso se vota. No hay que aceptar amor a Dios, a su iglesia, una iglesia que debemos amar y sentir, escuchando la Santa Misa los domingos, no importa lo que el cura diga, o lo que esto, que aquello, no. Olvidemos todas las debilidades de nuestros hermanos y de nuestros pastores, que hay. Debemos pensar que ellos son ministros del Señor, que hay que respetar. Que si tienen sus debilidades, bueno, eso es cosa de Dios con ellos. Nosotros no somos ninguna persona que estamos para juzgar a nadie. No podemos juzgar a las criaturas, a nadie. Entonces tenemos que callar, silenciar, resistir, aguantar, repudiar el mal, pero en silencio. Con la oración, acuérdense, la oración. Y el perdón, perdonar, siempre perdonar, no importa. Que te motejen, que se rían de ti, que digan que estás loco, que tú eres así, o eres asado. No, nada de eso. Tú eres tú con tu Dios. Es Él, un ser de nosotros. Así solamente podemos nosotros, verdaderamente, cantar las alabanzas al Señor, diciendo, santo, santo, santo Señor, Dios de los ejércitos, llenos están los cielos y la tierra de la majestad de nuestra gloria. Osana en el cielo. Bendito el que vino en nombre del Señor. Bendito el que viene en nombre del Señor. Bendito el que viene en nombre del Señor. Aleluya, aleluya, gloria.
Aleluya.
Con esto quiero significar que el Señor viene, pero que está conviviendo entre nosotros espiritualmente, en nuestros hogares y en nuestras casas. Y en el tabernáculo nos está esperando en todas las iglesias del mundo. Nuestra iglesia católica, para recibirlo, reciban al Señor, no dejen de recibirlo nunca, eso sí, hagan su confesión, por supuesto, porque el Señor no rechaza a ninguno de sus hijos, Dios nos quiere salvar a todos, recuerden esto, la comunión es el alimento de la alma, si yo no tomara la comunión, yo me sentiría muy mal, pero es la comunión, es que me da para esta parte. A mi madre, ella les va a tender las manos y los va a ayudar. Todos los que concienticen lo que es de Bai-TAHN-ee-uh, la madre se hará sentir en sus almas. Todos los que hayan venido con humildad y el santo temor de Dios podrán experimentar una paz inmensa en sus corazones. Yo amo, siempre lo digo y lo repito, el temor de Dios. Es un don maravilloso, el santo temor de Dios. Los dones del Espíritu Santo los amo todos, pero el temor de Dios
lo amo mucho. Porque cuando tú tienes a tu Dios, no es tenerlo a Él, sino el temor de no ofenderlo. Tú tienes a tu Dios porque no quieres ofenderlo. Ya ello es bastante. Y ese bastante es mucho y ese mucho es Dios que ha tocado tu corazón. Entonces, respeten mucho el santo temor de Dios, ese don maravilloso, para que no ofendan nunca al Señor, para que no ofendan a la Madre María, a Jesús, nuestro divino Jesús, amadísimo, el Señor nuestro, que clavado en la cruz derramó su sangre, para bañarnos, limpiarnos, purificarnos y hacernos mejores en la vida. Y que en estos tiempos Él se hace sentir en todos los corazones de los hombres, para que tomen su cruz cada uno, sin temor de que pese. El temor que debemos tener es no ofender a Dios. Entonces, vamos a concentrarnos. Pongan a toda su familia aquí en este momento. Piensen que la Madre María está en cada uno de vosotros. Allí está ella múltiple. Ella es múltiple María. Jesús, quien se hace sentir. El que no crea, que se calle. Silencio, por favor. Después pueden hablar, disculpen. Ven Espíritu Santo. Ven Espíritu Santo. Ven. Ven a esta persona. Embriáganos con el don de la sabiduría. Alumbranos con el don del buen entendimiento. Rígenos con el don del consejo. Confírmanos con el don. Ven. Confírmanos en nuestra fe. Cicatriza nuestras heridas. Límpianos, depúranos, haznos crecer. Suaviza nuestros corazones. Danos la gracia de poder sentir al Señor.
En el nombre de mi madre, yo los curo del cuerpo y del alma, y les guardo aquí en mi corazón. Guardaré tu corazón, guardaré aquí en mi corazón, y para siempre.
Way down here on the 19th floor. Now there's been Remember, this is going back.
Confusion and everything.
All right, well, I'm going to start on the first group here. There we go. Hey, Smiley, the one we almost forgot.
Hi, Al.
The one who has kept us straight and honest. The wife is hiding you. Is that a reason? All right, Brian, wave out here.
Come on, Brian. Give it up.
Jose, wake up.
Jose.
Carol.
Jose.
Is this other thing in front of you? Oh, that's my sister.
And there's George.
Hello.
George. Come on over, George. George. He's the one that sings Bai-TAHN-ee-uh.
This is the river that flows below Maria Esperanza's home, and also that flows below the grotto. This is the Blessed Mother. She appeared to Maria, told her that she will find a river and a stream. There's where she was to build the shrine of the Blessed Mother.
This is the hills surrounding the little valley in which Betania lays, and where the grotto and the church, I'm taking this from the church that was built in front of the grotto.
Time to be a waiter.
Thank you.
little chapel where we stopped to have lunch. You guys, before we sit down. And this is one of our friends that stopped in to have lunch with us. And he's lucky he wasn't eating for lunch. I think he likes the camera. He's kind of camera shy. I think this one's a little excited. He wants to know why he hasn't been selected to go visit with the group yet.
In the old time, they used to put, well, not in the old time, they still doing it. They used to put coffee here.
Uh-huh. Oh, and put coffee in there.
You sing Pilo, Pilo, Pilo. There are two ladies, you see. One lady here.
Yeah, the termite.
One, then the other.
Oh, this
one. Now they used to smash the coffee, but.
What is that wood? Hmm? What is the wood?
From any tree.
From any tree. Mm-hmm.
Peaceful and quiet out there.
This is beautiful.
This is what you got to get.
I recommend that we come here next time.
So great.
Yeah.
I'll go along with that.
This is beautiful. Serene, right next to...
With 30 people.
The lady.
Yes, right next to the...
5 minutes away.
Yes. If we could walk up.
As you can see, the countryside is gorgeous here. We just came through those doors, which brought us onto the other portion of this farm, or this, I call it a retreat. At least it sure looks like it would be a good retreat. George says this is his house. We got a nice pool. This is the entrance to one of the other little house, like the cabana. Good to be.
This is his house, Dad.
Huh?
This is George's house.
This is George's house?
Yeah.
I'm told this is George's place. This is his house.
Hello, sir.
This is George, right there. You can see this is quite a big farm. The next place that we'll visit will be this other compound. They're doing up there. Well, they have Jeff.
So they give the water.
Little creek runs next to this compound.
The Waco couple.
The fence that is built around the grotto is up over the hill.
Oh, you can't come this far.
The traffic freeway into the Caracas Hill.